Hi there, long time no see. And today I'm going to be talking about diets and cravings and binges. Oh my, just in time for Halloween. So, this is a subject that's really near and dear to my heart. What I want to share with you today is why dieting, why restriction is more likely to cause craving, more likely to cause food obsession, more likely to cause binges and overeating. Oh my. So before I begin, my name is Eve Lahijani. I'm a registered dietitian and I'm in love with sharing tips and tools like this to my Facebook community and beyond. So let's begin. So the first reason why diets backfire is because it restricts choices. Well, humans are not meant to be restricted when it comes to food and eating for a couple of very important reasons. First of all, when we restrict ourselves with food and eating, we might be missing out on important nutrition. I'm sure you have many friends who are following certain diets where they may cut out like whole food categories like fruits. Yeah, you miss out good nutrition there. Another problem with restricting your choices is what happens to us, not just physiologically, but psychologically. So you could think of your eating as something that's on a pendulum. Do you know what a pendulum is? You could think about the thing on the bottom of a grandfather's clock, or if you've ever seen the music video of Wrecking Ball, the Wrecking Ball, that's kind of like a pendulum. And what do you know about a pendulum? Is that when you swing it in one direction, what it wants to do is it wants to swing back in the opposite direction. Furthermore, if you take this pendulum and swing it really far in one direction, it wants to swing really far back. Well, what does this have to do with your food and eating? Everything. In that, people who are good at restricting themselves and depriving themselves of food, there's only a matter of time until there's an equal or greater backlash, which looks like binging, overeating, food obsession. So there's even a name for it. It's called diet backlash, and it's the inevitable swing back to overeating when people get too restrictive with their food and eating. And that's one of the ways that diets backfire. The second way that diets backfire is that when you go on a diet, it's so easy to be in your head, counting calories, measuring portions, feeling guilty for what you're eating, keeping track of points, the shame and the guilt. All of this stuff, where is that happening? All of that's happening in your head. But eating is meant to be a very physical thing. Eating is very sensual. It involves all of your senses, in fact. And so, if your mind can only truly focus on one thing at a time, which it can only focus on one thing at a time. So if your mind can only focus on one thing at a time, if you're busy feeling guilty for what you're eating, counting every calorie, measuring every portion, and yelling at yourself for every bite, what are the chances that you're paying attention and truly enjoying the food that's in front of you? Very little. Chances are you're really in your head about what you're eating. And here's the problem with that is when you're not enjoying your food, when you're not present with your food, you're not likely to be satisfied. And if you're not satisfied with your food, you're not going to stop. It may increase the likelihood of going on and going on. And so I want to share a client example I had. I have a client who I worked with years ago, and she was giving herself permission to have red vines. You know, it's kind of like licorice, but better, I think. Red vines, those red things you get at the movie theater. And so she was feeling really guilty for having these red vines. And with each bite, she counted every calorie. With each bite, she felt so guilty for what she was eating. And so, do you think she was satisfied after eating that one red vine? No, she wasn't, because the whole time she was in her head. So she figured, okay, I'm gonna have one more red vine, but this time I'm really gonna pay attention. This time I'm really gonna enjoy it. However, this was her second red vine. The voices in her head were even louder. She was yelling at herself for the fact that she was having a second red vine now. Oh my God, this is so horrible. And when she finished that second red vine, she still wasn't satisfied. So she went on to have a third red vine and a fourth. Can you guess what happened? If you guessed that she finished the entire box of red vines, you're right. And the sad part of the story isn't that she finished that whole box of red vines. The sad part of the story is she ate that whole box of red vines and she still wasn't satisfied. And the reason is because she was so in her head the whole time she was eating. She wasn't present with her food. So it's so important to enjoy what you're eating, because when you enjoy what you're eating, you're more likely to feel satisfied. And when you're satisfied, it makes it a lot easier to stop when you're done eating. So that's the second reason why diets backfire. You're not able to enjoy your food, you're more likely to feel unsatisfied, and you're more likely to eat continuously. The third reason why diets backfire is that it purposely creates a disconnect between your mind and your body. What do I mean by that? Anybody who's been on a diet knows that, you know, to be successful on this diet, you may have to ignore the signals of the body. I'm sure you've read about things or heard about things people may do to ignore their body. Like, they have these special tricks. Like, if you're hungry, to fool your body that it's eaten, you know, have a glass of water, or have smoke a cigarette, or chew gum, or drink sparkling water. Well, first of all, none of these things work. Your body is a lot smarter than that. But the problem with doing these things is, as you get good at training your brain, teaching your brain that it's okay to ignore your body's hunger, the brain also learns that it's okay to ignore the body's fullness. You can't just ignore one side of the equation. So the really sad thing about this is that people who get good at ignoring their hunger are also the same people that are good at ignoring their fullness. Because again, you can't ignore just one side of the equation. And what's the problem with ignoring your fullness? Well, consistently overeating, well, that starts to get very uncomfortable and is another reason why diets backfire. The fourth reason why diets backfire is a loss of power that occurs when you go on a diet. So, when you've gone on a diet in the past, who tells you what to eat? The diet. If you've gone on a diet, who tells you how much you're allowed to eat? The diet. When you go on a diet, who tells you when you're allowed to eat? The diet. Dude, these diets are very controlling. And now let me tell you a problem with this. It's part of normal, healthy psychology is a sense of autonomy. A sense that your choices matter. It's part of Maslow's hierarchy of needs, is part of self-actualization, is making your choices for yourself. Well, this includes food choices. Now, if that sense of autonomy is threatened by too many rules, even if you put those food rules on yourself, there's only a matter of time until the diet rebel comes out. You know, when you make choices that you feel are not in your best interest because nobody's looking, or you tell yourself, I know I shouldn't be eating this, but I am. Have you ever told yourself that, or have you ever heard a friend be saying that? The reason why that happens is because your little diet rebel comes out, and the diet rebel does everything you wish it wouldn't do. And whenever that diet rebel comes out, it's always an indicator that you're being too restrictive, that you're putting too many arbitrary rules on yourself. And again, this might not be you, this might be a friend or a loved one. So please pass this video on if you know somebody who does any of these patterns. So the fourth reason that diets backfire is that loss of power that occurs, and our diet rebel comes out and does the exact opposite. And now the fifth reason why diets backfire is that it avoids life issues. And what I mean by that is, life could be a stressful place. We have a lot going on. We have finances, we have the government, we have traffic. I mean, so many different things, taxes, so many things to deal with, right? And oftentimes, as a way to feel more in control, people figure, well, I'll go on a diet. I'll start to become rigid with my food and my exercise. And although that may might sound wise and like a good thing to do, the problem with this is that when we use food to have a perceived sense of control, to control our stress, well, once stress hits a higher threshold, because it will for this person, because they never learn how to deal with their stress in the first place. So when stress hits this higher threshold, well, guess what? Food starts to work emotionally. So we're more likely to eat emotionally. We're more likely to eat compulsively if we have a history of dieting, because food works, because food now has a meaning. So I hope that made sense. I hope all of this made sense. I wonder what parts you could relate to the most, you know, in your experience. Why have diets backfired for you? I mean, I just shared the most common that I see in my practice. I know I struggled with each of these things. There's also diets backfire because they ruin your metabolism. So just to recap, diets backfire. They cause cravings. They're more likely to cause binges, obsession with food. And the reason why diets backfire is because it restricts choices. It denies enjoyment. Dieting purposely creates a disconnect between your mind and your body. So if you're good at restricting, you're also good at overeating, ignoring that fullness also. Also, when people go on diets, a loss of power occurs, and that diet rebel is more likely to happen. And finally, when people go on diets, it avoids the issues. We never learn coping skills. So when stress hits a higher threshold, we're more likely to use food emotionally. We're more likely to eat compulsively, which is another reason why diets backfire. So I hope this was helpful. And some of you might be thinking, well, how do I undo all this? I know when I share this with classes or individuals or groups, most people can relate with a lot of this stuff. So how to undo all this? Well, I have a few tips for you. First of all, get off diets. Captain Obvious here, right? So one of the best things you could do with for yourself is to get off diets once and for all. And I understand for many of you, this could be the scariest thing. I know for me, I've done a lot of scary things in my life, and maybe getting off diets was one of the hardest and scariest things I've ever done. So first thing, get off diets. Second thing is learn how to reconnect with your body. What does hunger feel like for you? Yeah. What does fullness feel like in your body? And also, when it comes to reconnecting with your body, it also means reconnecting with, what does it feel like when you're getting sleepy? Angry? How about stressed? Loneliness? Right? So part of reconnecting with yourself is learning how to navigate these feelings and what to do in each of these situations. Another really important tip is learn how to make balanced nutrition choices. Learn how to balance your food so you're not overeating because you're so deprived. So you're not overeating because of a nutritional inadequacy. And finally, a bonus tip is, you know, start to have compassion for yourself. Learn how to forgive yourself for your eating that doesn't go quite the way you want it to. I know this is a lot of heavy stuff. It's way easier said than done. And so that's why I'm here. So if there's anything I could do for you, if you need support with any of this, anything that I mentioned in this whole talk, please feel free to visit my website, vitamineve.com. Please leave me a message. I'll respond to your email in the next 24 to 48 hours. If you're watching this on Facebook, you could send me a private message, or you could email me directly at Vitamin Eve, which is VitaminEve at hotmail.com. I'd love to hear from you. So I hope you enjoyed this message. Thank you for watching, and I hope to hear from you. Have a great Halloween. Bye.